data were gathered from 96 programs. So we have 96 programs in 36 of the 54 hours. It's there. My issue today, of course, is to what degree it's accessible to students in Danville. They found 12 centers of excellence that they kind of, I guess, subjectively elected, with some thought to other things that they offer, of course. Then they found nine centers, or designated nine centers, centers of reference. So those are, I guess, the second tier centers. They report, though, and I definitely won't go through every issue, but you have many analyses, many recommendations, and of course, several conclusions, among which are that Africa still is far from developing continental or sub-regional associations, let alone what they call prime or pan-African accredited systems, as we have in their accreditation system. So UNESCO, however, still elects to work with institutions which may turn into leadership positions, and they may turn into leadership organizations. And also, again, they look toward working with the ones that are, again, second tier. The report also acknowledged that there was widespread criticism by many of the African media industry. So those in the African media industry criticized the work being done by journalism schools. So, despite that criticism, the project recommended that Africa does not need any new or more journalism schools. So while the structure is there, it's still problematic in terms of the training. Four key points I definitely want to share with you that Dr. Plasson extrapolated from being there. One, that African journalism schools are small by necessity, that makes sense. Choice also, and they're highly competitive.